think of spies, they might be larger-than-life Secret Service agents we see in Hollywood, perhaps like those from the hit TV show Homeland.
Law enforcement needs to stop harassing and demonising an entire community.
What are you doing here?
Salaam alaikum, Seikum. We were contacted to handle your case.
We took a look at your website. The FBI is saying it's material support for a foreign terrorist organization.
Get your hands off of me!
Since when is engaging in political debate online a punishable offense?
And its intent is to motivate people to attack the United States.
Stand down.
No, you stand down.
No Saul?
No Saul.
It's probably for the best.
Love that show. It's always action-packed. But what about the real deal, our homegrown Australian intelligence agents? How do their lives stack up in comparison to their fictional counterparts? Well, Warren Reid was an Australian spy for 10 years and a former officer of the Australian Secret Intelligence Service. And he joins us now. Welcome to the show. Warren, is that your real name?
As far as I know, it is.
So tell us about life as a spy.
Well, most people know about the fundamental duality of spying, that you've got a cover job and then you've got the spying work that you're doing deep down underneath that. But there is actually a third world that you live in, which is who you are yourself, what your sense of identity is, sometimes your ethics and whatnot. And that third world is the one that goes down the gurgler quickly if there's an emergency in the other two.
What was your cover job?
I worked mainly out of embassies, Australian embassies.
Oh, overseas. Diplomat.
Yeah, which is fairly common, but just one cover role.
And how is it that you're... I mean, is someone going to now take you out because you're blowing your cover on this? How are you able to talk about
this? Well, there are many reasons why I'm talking in the public domain, why I'm known. Which we don't really need to go into. But, any former officer, I mean, in America, former CIA men and women, you know, talk, they write books, they do all sorts of things. And we're fairly primitive in that regard here. But no former intelligence officer would ever talk about detailed, sensitive, operational things.
So what sort of thing, without going into specifics, what sort of things would you do and who would tell you to do them?
And did you kill anyone?
that's a question you always get.
With your shoe phone.
Just the odd politician here and there. No, what you're usually after is the foreign country you're working in, is that country's most closely guarded secrets that your government back home wants. So inside a bureaucratic system, there'll be many, many people who are reading the product of Australian spies coming in from overseas, and they guide you in what you should be looking at.
Right.
So there are standing requirements that never fizzle, and there can be other requirements that would be transitory, maybe just for a week or something.
And
like
you're
that.
Always trying to talk to certain people and get them to reveal a bit more than they otherwise would, and then you would put this and send this in reports, briefing reports.
Yeah, well, it's slightly different in the sense that we all know there's a lot of cyber warfare, cyber intelligence work, the NSA in America and whatnot. But human spying is all about human relations. And the big factor is that you can't walk into the places where these secrets are kept and just nick off with them in the still of the night.
So you
recruit
it?
Other people with the access to do that for you. So those people, if you recruit them, you often take over people who your predecessor had recruited earlier when you arrive at a place. But you trawl around and you identify so people with access.
These are foreign nationals who are working for foreign
in their country.
Yeah.
So you've got to cultivate them and build up a relationship whereby they will not just give you secrets, but the security of the relationship really resides in your knowing as much about them as you can. So you encourage them to see you as a friend, as a mentor, a counsellor, all sorts of things.
They're betraying their country for you.
Oh, that's what they're doing.
So you mentioned you had three lives. How did you go about juggling three lives?
Oh, with considerable difficulty.
And how does your family manage that?
Well, it takes a toll on marriages.
And are you married?
No.
Right.
It's if you're not married when you're overseas as a spy, you've got sort of all your emotional, psychological energy to devote to that pursuit, and you grab time off when you can. But for married people, really tricky.
If you were married, could you tell your wife or your husband that you were a spy?
Most people do tell their spouse.
Mm. Right.
And
that's kosher?
Yeah. Right. Oh, usually you tell your service, or they will ask you.
Yep.
Now, who are the key people in your life that you should tell? Because they're the people that others will go to if they suspect what you're doing. So those people can protect your cover.
Did you ever not feel that you were putting them in danger?
No, not really. No, because they're not overseas.
So what's your agenda with coming out? I don't mean it for closet.
yeah, touchy question.
Yes.
No, as I said, I happen to be in the public arena for all sorts of reasons.
Mm.
So if anybody wants to talk about this craft, I'm a ready person to discuss it.
Okay.
And so what is the craft then? Why did you want to be a spy? And is it about being a good liar?
Yeah, well, in many ways, that's what it boils down to. Most people have never wanted to be that. Like, when you're a kid, you resolve that one day when I'm 8, I'm going to be a spy. Usually you're approached by the service. Someone will identify you in the community and tip the spy service off to the fact that you're around and they'll watch you for a while.
Really?
Nowadays, as far as I know, please trust me. But the service will usually approach you. But nowadays you can apply online.
Did anything go on?
I've actually seen recruitment drives for ACES in cinemas.
Wow.
Yeah.
Which is good. You know, it should be out there.
Did anything go on behind the scenes that you didn't agree with?
Torture.
No.
Well, that was my next. Yeah.
Is that what you're sort of getting?
Yeah, it is. I mean,
no, it's it's not a nice thing to talk about. But when you're away overseas as a spy, you every now and again trip over a relationship that are nasty, like a Russian or something. Someone has with a prominent person in our community in the bureaucracy, state, federal parliament, whatever, military, and reporting that back to your headquarters won't always attract the attention that you think it should get.
Right.
So things like that tend to be very touchy.
Are there many relationships that our political leaders have with dubious foreign government powers?
Should we be worried about Russia?
I think we should be more worried about Russia than China. I think Chinese intelligence...
Didn't include Korea in that.
Well, North Korea is a case all off by itself on a different planet, isn't it? I think the Chinese, while they do obviously try to influence events in other countries politically and whatnot, they're largely after intelligence that's important to them. The big difference with the Russians is that their primary task is not just to get secret intelligence, but to implant people, sleepers, illegals, deep down into, say, American society and influence events in a negative way, disrupt things. Have meetings with people like in Washington, Trump's son and son-in-law, where even if the purpose of the meeting isn't clear, the purpose was just to have a meeting and create a sequence of likely collusion.
Yeah.
So they're spoilers in a different way to what the Chinese are.
Mm.
We could talk to you about this all day, but if you stay much longer, you will self-destruct.
Well,
as a special treat for our studio audience, you're all going home with a copy of Homeland, season 6 on DVD, so you can indulge your inner spy. How cool is that? Warren Reid, you are just such a fascinating bloke.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks so much for coming by.